have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the dream.
Strength Team family, look, I'm right back with another great video. If you're new to the Strength Team family, welcome to the Strength Team family. All we do over here is get gains. If you have any video suggestions or any video requests, all you got to do is put them at the bottom, and I promise you I'm going to make that video happen. Now, as you see, I'm back in the old gym. I trained at the house for like 2 to 3 weeks. That way I can make some videos for people that train at the house and show them how you can still get gains. I've made some pretty good gains, and listen, I didn't have a lot to work with. Now, don't get it wrong, I'm going to go back to my home gym, but I'm going to go ahead and get it finished. And once I get finished, then I'll probably just train at the home gym like 80% of the time and still go to the gym like 20% of the time. What I got today is a killer back workout. And the crazy thing about it, it's only 4 exercises. That's way too much talking, so let's jump straight into this workout. Our first exercise, we have the underhand barbell row. We have 4 total sets, and we're going to stay between 8 to 10 reps. Now listen, I want you to go as heavy as you can, but at the same time, make sure you're keeping decent form. Now I want you to increase the weight every single set. Now your third set, I want you to do a drop set. So like you're seeing the video, I want you to go for like 8 to 10 reps. Immediately, after you get 8 to 10 reps, go ahead and lighten the weight up a little bit, and then I want you to go right back in our strength team and do another 8 to 10 reps. Now that fourth set is going to be your heaviest set. I think I had 275 pounds, and I'm not even going to lie to you. This set right here, your form is going to be a little bit sloppy, but it's a double drop set, so you have plenty of time to clean up your reps. So like you're seeing the video, I think I got like 6, maybe 7 reps. Then I jerked off the weight down to 185 pounds, and then I went right back in our strength team, and I think I got another like 8 to 10 reps. Now I want you to drop some weight off again, so it was 135 pounds, and this is when your form should be almost picture perfect. Make sure your reps are clean. Like you're seeing the video, I want you to pull your elbows all the way back, bring that barbell inside of your hips, squeeze your back at the top, and then get that deep stretch all the way out. I want you to keep going until you cannot rep one more rep. Do not even count reps. If you got 12, give it 12. If you got 20, give it 20. Save nothing. Now after finished with that, we have the V-bar seated cable rows. We have 4 sets, and we're going to stay between 8 to 10 reps. Again, I want you to go heavy as you possibly can. Increase the weight every single set. My first set was 200 pounds. My second set was 220 pounds. My third set was 250 pounds, and that is a drop set. So your third set's going to be a drop set. So I want you to pull that weight, driving your elbows all the way back. Now go ahead and stretch your lats out and get a deep stretch, and repeat that until you get like 8 to 10 reps. Immediately after you get 8 to 10 reps for your third set on your drop set, go ahead and lighten that weight up, and then now you have the static holds. So after you get your 8 to 10 reps, lighten the weight up. I think I went from 250 pounds all the way down to 120. That sounds kind of light, but you got to think, you are literally holding that bar against your chest for 1 to 2 to even 3 seconds every single rep. So then let it come all the way back out, then drive your elbows right back, and then hold and squeeze. When you got that bar against your chest, I want you to think about squeezing your back as hard as you possibly can. And I want you to take this set to failure. Now, your fourth set is going to be a double drop set. We're going to make it even more interesting. So this is going to be your heaviest set in strength team. I did 300 pounds. I maxed out the machine, so your boy is getting stronger. I think I got like 8, maybe even 9 reps. It's my double drop set. So the first drop set, I want you to have a 2 to 3 second stretch. So like you're seeing a video, I want you to bring it to your chest, squeeze, now come out and hold it. I want you just to hold it for like 2 to 3 seconds and think about just stretching your lats out. Now drive it right back and squeeze your back. Now come right back out again and just stretch. Think about your lats. Let your lats just get a deep stretch. In your head, count 1 to 2 to even 3 seconds and drive it back. Now once you go until you cannot do another rep, I want you to lighten the weight up again for your double drop set. And this time I want you just to control your negatives. So like you're seeing the video, I want you to drive your elbows all the way back. Squeeze your back. Now count 1, 2, 3 on the way out, and try to keep the tension in your lats. It's going to make your lats come alive, and then drive your elbows right back. I want you to do this and take it to failure. Now, after finish with that, you're going to have a crazy pump in your lats. Your back is going to be pumped. You're going to feel good, and honestly, you're going to be somewhat exhausted. But listen, we only got a couple more exercises, so let's go ahead and finish strong. So our third exercise, we have the V-bar lat pull downs. We have 3 sets, and I want you to stay between 12 to 15 reps. I do not want you to go heavy on this. I want you to save say it again. I do not want you to go heavy with this. I want you to put an arch in your back. I want you to stick your chest straight up, and I want you to drop that bar right below your chest. Not necessarily to your stomach, but I want it to be right up under your chest and squeeze. I want every single rep to look like this. That's why I say you do not have to go heavy, because I want you to focus on controlling the weight and contracting your back and also stretching your lats. Now, that third set, you already know what time it is. We're gonna do a drop set. So after I got my 12 reps, I think I even had my partner to help me. I immediately lightened that weight up by maybe like 40 to 50 pounds, and then I just took that set to failure. I think I only got like maybe 10, maybe 11 reps. Now, to finish with that, we're gonna finish our back off. We have the resistance band hyperextensions. We have three sets for 12 to 15 reps, but listen, strength team, this right here is gonna tie in everything that we have done so far. This exercise right here is so slept on. I hardly see anybody doing it. It is probably one of the most effective back exercises that you can do. Like you see in the video, just go ahead and get your resistance band tied to something stable. Now you're just gonna grab it with both arms. Now I want you just to perform a regular hyperextension on your way down. Make sure you already have tension. Now as you're coming up, think about driving your elbows back as you're coming up. And then at the top, just squeeze your entire back. Your whole back should be contracted. I mean, your whole posterior chain will be. I mean, I can feel it from my calves, from my hamstrings, even my glutes, my erectors, all the way up to my traps. Your whole entire posterior chain is going to come alive. Exaggerate that stretch. Take your hands all the way down and try to touch the ground. But make sure you still are keeping tension on that resistance band. And then I want you to repeat that for every single rep. Strength team, I'm not going to lie to you. That's only four exercises and my back felt amazing. But you already know traps are one of my weak areas. So I try to hit my traps at least two times a week. Sometimes I hit them with a lot of volume. Sometimes I hit them with a lot of intensity. I already had a decent pump, so I just went ahead and just did some dumbbell shrugs. I did four sets and I stayed between 12 to 15 reps. It was nothing fancy. I just made sure that I could feel that contraction at the top, and I almost exaggerate that stretch at the bottom. What I mean by that is I almost think about letting the dumbbells pull my traps down, but I let it do it safely, because you can also hurt your neck if you do this kind of carelessly. So when you do this, be mindful for that. I don't want you to hurt yourself, but at the same time, I do want you to stretch your traps. The more you can stretch your traps, the stronger and the bigger they're going to build. But like I said, we have 3 to 4 sets. We're going to stay between 12 to 15 reps. Also, we have a killer arm workout coming up, so I didn't want to do a lot of bicep work. You got to think, your bicep has already worked a lot just doing all these heavy pulls. So we did one exercise, and we did the dumbbell sideways hammer curl. We had three sets, and we're going to stay between 10 to 12 reps. My weight was 50 pounds. You do not have to use a lot of heavy weight, but at the same time, don't use no baby weight, strength team. I want you to use a weight that you can control for you to be able to get 10 to 12 reps. If you can get way more than 10 to 12 reps, listen, go ahead and add some weight. If you're struggling to get like 6 or 7 reps, go ahead and drop your ego down, and trust me, go ahead and lighten that weight up. Like I said in the video, keep your chest up high, bring the dumbbell up right close to your chest, now squeeze your bicep. Now come down somewhat slow and controlled, and then bring your other arm up and squeeze, and then come back down in a slow, controlled manner. That's all I want you to do, slow and controlled, 10 to 12 reps, and that is it. This workout right here, strength team, was gain certified. I actually miss training at the gym. I just forgot. It's so much easier because everything is right here. The dumbbells, I don't have to take off no plates and put on a plate or run upstairs and get this or run downstairs and do that. It's all right there. So I ain't gonna lie to you. I kind of miss the gym, and I'm glad that I'm back at the gym. It's just the atmosphere, being around all the people that I've trained with over the past 4 years. Watch them grow. Watch me grow. It was just great to be back. But like I tell you in every single video, strength team, make sure you like this video. Make sure you share this video. But at the end of the day, strength team, make sure you keep getting them gains.
You have to eat the dream. You have to sleep the dream. You have to dream the dream.